think I spend more than 90% of my time on new code.
So new very features. Little maintenance. And what type of maintenance do you generally end up doing?
Yeah, mostly we have bugs in CSS or cross-browser compatibility issues, so not really Elm things.
Yeah, we're always focusing on new functionality.
So, you know, that, you know, if it, you know, if you figure, you know, if you maybe had to have two engineers, you know, and if you were using JavaScript, you might have to have two or three engineers just focused on fix-it maintenance. So, you know, you might be saving right there 300,000 euros a year. Mm-hmm. I mean, and I'll note, I will note that every JavaScript project I had before I started discovered Elm, there was some point in the project where all I wanted to do was go crawling up in a corner and cry because I couldn't figure it out. And that has not happened to me in Elm.
No.
I mean, I've occasionally not been able to figure something out, but it usually...
No, we don't have that problem.
Yeah.
And also, I think, of course, with a code base of a certain size, like if you're using JavaScript, like you end up like, okay, where does this happen? So it's like with Elm, like you're really quickly at like the point where it actually is happening instead of like searching through files and going back and forth between.
I'd actually forgotten about that.
Yeah, but it's like, as I said, like it's one of the things, like if you're using it, like you get so used to it. But like if you have a logic error, I think like within a couple of seconds you're in the right module. And like if you were using something else, it would sometimes take a considerable amount of time to actually find the code that is causing the error.
I find that sometimes bugs that probably would have taken me 8 or 12 hours to debug in JavaScript.
Mm-hmm.
You know, cause something is inconsistent, you know, a field name got spelled differently or something. In Elm, it's like a compiler error and I'm fixed in a minute.